Vallejan.
The following is a class on the Bhagavad Gita as it is. Fourth chapter, text number 17, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on the 6th of April, 1974, in Bombay, India.
The same principle of working order is being discussed by Krishna again in this verse. Beginning was Chaturvarnamaya system Gunakarma Vibhava. We should remember the same principle always. Four classes are divided according to quality and karma. Therefore, Krishna says, karmana api bodhavyam. What is actually what? Bodhavyam cha vikarmana. Vikarmana means forbidden. This is the human life's business. He should know what is actual what and what is forbidden what. Just like a good citizen knows what is lawful what and what is unlawful what. Lawful work is executed by intelligent citizens and unlawful work is executed by the criminals. He has to suffer. You can cheat the man-made government by hiding yourself, so-called hiding. You cannot hide yourself from any vikarma or unlawful work from the eyes of the Supreme Lord. That is not possible. You can hide yourself from the eyes of the police, man-made law, but it is not possible to hide yourself from the eyes of the Supreme. That is not possible. Because the Supreme is sitting within your heart. Ishara sarvabhutanam vidyeshe arjuna tishtati. And he is sitting as anumanta and upadrashta. He is simply seeing what you are doing. And he is giving sanction also. Even a thief who is going to act something criminally without the sanction of the super soul who is sitting within everyone's heart. He cannot do that. That we have got experience. Suppose we are going to do something which is not very good. The conscience is beating. No, no, you should not do this. You should not do this. But because without the sanction of the Supreme, I cannot do anything. So, if we persist to do something, then the sanction is given at your risk. That is going on. God does not give you sanction for doing anything criminal. But if we persist to do something criminal, then God gives sanction, all right, do it at your risk. That is going on. Karmana daivana trena. Now, when we act something on account of my persistence, by the sanction of the law, then I become subjected to the fruits of such resultant action. And we get a different type of body. That is going on. In the Shastra it is said, karmana daivanetrena jantar deha upapatti. Jantar are the living entity. We are getting different types of bodies. Just like you are sitting, so many people, ladies and gentlemen, everyone's bodily feature is different from the other. So why there are different features? We are all human beings. Why we have got different types of bodies? Not only in human society, the animal society, the bird society, it is all karmana by our personal, fruitive action, karmana daivinatrena. This law we do not know. We work irresponsibly without knowing the result of our work. Therefore, we are getting different types of bodies, different types of situation, different type of occupation, so many things. Therefore, people should be trained, as Krishna has said in the beginning, the chaturvarnam maya system gunakarma vibhava. The four classes of men, according to quality, they should be engaged in different types of occupation. Guna karma. First of all, guna. Guna means quality. In the material world also, practically we see, if we want to work in a certain type of occupation, first of all, it is examined whether I have got the quality. Suppose if I want to work as an engineer, so I must possess the quality first of all, whether I can act as an engineer. Similarly, if I want to work as a lawyer, then I must have the qualification. Similarly, different type of quality, different type of qualification, and then different type of work. Guna karma vibhava. So, that requires guidance. And who is the guide? The father is the guide. The king, the government is the guide. The elder, the guru is the guide. There must be guide. Guru nasasya, pita nasasya, janani nasasya. In this way, sajana nasasya, namo chayaja samapeta mrityam. These laws are unknown at the present moment in this age. There are so many gurus, so many fathers, so many relatives, so many husbands. There are so many guides, but they do not know what is the aim of life. Therefore, Shastra says that if you do not know what is the aim of life, you should not become a guru. You should not become a father. You should not become a mother. Janani na sasyat. So, what is the aim of life? The aim of life, namo chayaja samupeta mrittum. Samupeta mrittum, we have got this disease. Mrittu, we have to die. We are making so many plans for our happiness. But where is the plan for stopping your death? That is the ultimate goal of life. But they do not know it. Namo chayaja samupeta mrittum. Krishna says, everything is explained in the Bhagavad Gita. Therefore, we are repeatedly asking everyone to study Bhagavad Gita as it is. Don't become a learned scholar and interpret foolishly, differently from Bhagavad Gita. That is not really. As it is. As Krishna says, try to understand Bhagavad Gita. Everything is there. So Krishna said that our real problem of life is janma mittu jarabhyadi, dukkha dosanu dasana. That is the problem. Repetition of birth, bhutya bhutya praliyate, we take one body according to karma, karma nada imanetrena, jantur diha upapatti. We get a body according to karma, daivanetrena. That is not in your hand. Suppose if you are living like cats and dogs, the nature's way is that you get next life the dog's body, cat's body or hog's body. And if you are working just like a god, godly, with good qualification, godly qualification, then you become next life demigod. you get your situation in the higher planetary system. These are all explained in the Bhagavad Gita. How do you know? Urdhaṁ gacchanti sattvastvā. If you act just like a qualified brahmana, sattvastvā, sattvastvā means brahmana, then you get your promotion in the higher planetary system, urdhaṁ. Urdhaṁ gacchanti sattvastvā. If you act like a brahmana, then get your promotion to the higher planetary system, janaloka, mahaloka, tapaloka, brahmaloka, siddhaloka. There are so many planets. The people do not know. There is no such education. But we have got this knowledge from the Vedic literature. Urdhaṁ gacchanti sattvastvā. Madhye tishtanti rajasa. If you have got the qualification of rajagun, creative energy, then you remain in the middle planetary system, bhūr-bhūvasya, those who are Brahmins, knows Gayatri Mantra, Om bhūr-bhūvasya, and jagannaguna-vittisya adogacchanti tamasa. Tamasa, tamagun, jaganna, abominable, nasty, unclean, eating nasty things, then jaganna guna vittista adogacchanti tamasa. They go to the lower priority system, tal, atal, vital, patal, tarsatal, talatal. There are so many planets. Or in the animal kingdom. So we are creating our next body, karmana, by our work. Therefore Krishna says, karmanopi buddhavam. You must know, because you have to accept next body. You can talk foolishly, no, there is no body. Vashyabhutasya, that is the atheistic theory. The after the body is born to ashes, everything is finished. Big professor, big learned scholar, so-called scholar, they say like that, no, there is no life. Everything is finished after this body is finished. But that is not a fact. If we have to accept the authority of Bhagavad Gita, we have to accept it. If we don't accept, that is our foolishness. Bhagavan says, tathādehāntara-prāpti dehinasmin tathādehi kumumārjavunam jadā. Tathādehāntara. Dehāntara-prāpti is there. As we are getting dehāntara, we have got experience every day. Just like in daytime, we have got this body. At night, when you dream, we have got a divine body. We go elsewhere, working differently, forgetting this body. And again, daytime, we forget our body which was seen in the dream. But that is also dream, this is also dream. This is daydream and that is night dream. But the seer, the soul, is permanent. He is in the daytime and he is also nighttime. So this is our position. We are changing our body. Just like I was a child, you are a child. But that we have forgotten. But that does not mean I did not have. Similarly, in the past I had a body, in the present I have got a body, then why not in the future? This is common sense. In future we must have a body. Tathādehāntara-prāpti. Krishna says, authority. I may say, there is no body, but Krishna says there is body. And how this body is manufactured? Karmanā, by your work. If you work foolishly in the kamagun, then you get the body of ignorance, ugly body, abominable body, poor body, without any education, without any knowledge. And if you work satagun, then you get better body. And the rajagun, then in the middle class body, these are stated in the Shastra, you have to accept it. Therefore Krishna says, karmano javi buddhavyam, buddhavyam cha vikarmana. Vikarmana means forbidden work. you should not do this. Just like we are forbidding our students no illicit sex. This is forbidden. No intoxication. This is forbidden in the Shastra. Yatra Papas Chaturvidha. Four kind of sinful activities. These are the basic pillars, four pillars of sinful activities. Illicit sex life and intoxication, meat eating and gambling. Vidasunapanadurga Yatra Papas Chaturvidha. The four kinds of sinful activity. So if we act sinfully, then we get a body which is result of sinful action. By pious activities, we get Janma Isabja Sutta Sri. Janma, first class family, first class nation, Janma. That is very important thing, to get birth in first class family, enlightened family, Brahmana family. Shishinam Simatamgehi Yoga Bhrishta Sanjayati. These are all explained in the Bhagavad Gita. Yoga Bhrishta. Suppose one has taken to Krishna consciousness. Bhakti Yoga. So, if you can execute properly, then Bhaktyamam Vijanadi Javanjasthani Tattata Tatomang Tattato Gatya Vishati Tadanantaram. Then you will understand what is God, what is Kingdom of God. And after that, he shall enter into the Kingdom of God. Tatta deham punarjanma naiti. So this is the only shelter. If you take to Bhakti Yoga, even if you fail to execute it properly, then still you are guaranteed your next life, suchinam simatange. In the family of nice brahmana or very rich man, you'll get born. Suchinam means first class brahmin, Vaishnav, suchi, jasare pundari kathang, badhya pantaram, suchi. Suchi means brahman. And muchi means cobbler. Muchi means cobbler. There is a Bengali verse. Suchi hoye muchi hoy. Jadi Krishna Taji. The first line is Muchi hoye suchi hoy. Jadi Krishna bhaje. One who takes to Krishna consciousness, even he is born in the family of cobbler, Muchi. Everyone knows, Indians. So, Muchi hoye suchi hoy. Although he is born in the family of a Muchi, cobbler, he becomes suchi, a brahmana. By Jodi Krishna Bhaji, if he is a devotee of Krishna, if he is in Krishna consciousness, and Muchi hai, Suchi hai, Jodi Krishna Bhaji, and Suchi hai, Muchi hai, Jodi Krishna Taji. If one is born of a Brahmin family, but gives up Krishna Bhajan, devotional life, he becomes a Muchi. Karmana, because he changed his karma, therefore, chaturvanna maya system, guna karma vibhavasa. This education should be introduced. Guna. First of all, everyone should be educated to accept the sataguna, sattvic, goodness. Everyone should be trained up. The first class good man, satta, sama, dama, pritikya, arjava, jnanam, vijnanam, astikam, brahma karma sabhava. If he remains like an animal, eating, sleeping and mating and dying like cats and dogs, that is not right. Therefore Krishna says, what type of karma should one execute? Karmanopi bodhavyam. One should learn. Not foolishly do anything and anything. Like the Shudras. Shudras also have got their duty, particular duty that explains all time. But if we take to Krishna consciousness, it doesn't matter whether one is possessing the Brahminical qualification or the Kshatriya qualification or Vaishya qualification or Shudra qualification, it doesn't matter. If one is taken to the service of Krishna consciousness, He is above all this Brahmana, Kshatriya, Vaishya, Shudra. That type of karma. Therefore it is called karma yoga. Karma, you have certain type of tendency to work. To work in that. Sakarmanatam abhyas. That is the recommendation that according to your qualification, you work, but by the result of your work, you worship Krishna, the Supreme Personality of God. That is the point. That is Krishna consciousness. It is not that everyone is expected to become first-class Brahminical culture. It doesn't matter. The same example. This is an example I've given in the Srimad Bhagavad. Mukho bahu urupadebhya purusasya asramaisaha chattaru yogyirevanna vipradaya bhunatrikha. Vipradaya bhunatrikha. If we understand what is the meaning of becoming Brahmana, what is the meaning of becoming Kshatriya, what is the meaning of becoming a Vaishya, and what is the meaning of becoming a Shudra, that is described in the Srimad Bhagavatam. Mukha bahu urupadebhya. Mukha means the face, bahu means the arms, uru means the waist, and pada, these legs. So, mukha bahu urupadebhya. This Brahmana and the Kshatriya and the Vaishya and the Shudra, it should be taken as the different parts of the body of the Virata Purusha. So, the Brahmana's business, you can understand the mouth, you have got the tongue. Brahmana's business is to eat and to chant Vedic mantras. Therefore, to give eatables to the Supreme Lord, according to our Vedic principle, the Brahmanas are called and they are given foodstuff. So you eat. By your eating, Krishna will eat. And that has been misused now. That actually that is the meaning. In the Vedic literature, they do not say that for some pious activities, you call some poor man. No, Brahmanas. Brahman bhojan. Because the Brahmana is supposed to be the mouth of God. Similarly, Kshatriya is supposed to be the arms of God. The Vaishyas, the waist of God. And the Shudras, the legs of God. But God is absolute. Therefore, there is no distinction between mouth or the leg. If you offer flowers and tulsi on the lotus feet of God, Krishna, and if you decorate the mouth of Krishna, it is the same. Because there is no difference of the mouth and leg. Provided the mouth is working as mouth and the leg is working as leg for satisfying the Supreme, then there is no such distinction. As soon as Krishna consciousness is absent, the so-called Brahmin is popped up. Why, I am born in Brahmin family. I am bigger than the Shudras. That is fall down. The real purpose is that either you be mouth or hand or waist or leg. The real purpose is to maintain the body very perfectly. That is the real purpose. Similarly, either you become Brahmana, or you become Kshatriya, or you become Shudra, or Vaishya. Real purpose is how to satisfy Krishna. That is explained in Bhagavatam. Atapungi vijasreshta varnasama vibhadas sanusthitasya dharmasya sangsiddhi haritosam. The real purpose is whether you are satisfying Krishna. If that aim is lost, that you do not require to satisfy Krishna, you simply satisfy your senses, then it has no meaning. Jayasam purusam saksha atma prabhavam isharam na bhajanti abhajananti sthanad bhrashta patanti ada. Sthanad bhrashta, I claim, it is very simple to understand. Suppose this hand, my hand, but how long it is had, so long it is attached to the service of the body. If this hand is cut off from this body, it may be called hand, but it has no meaning. Similarly, head also. The head is head so long it is attached to the body. If the head is cut off from the body, then what is the meaning of this head? It has no meaning. Similarly, either you become Brahmana, or you become Kshatriya, or you become Vaishya or Shudra. If you are not attached to the service of the Supreme Whole, then you are useless Brahman, useless Kshatriya, useless Vaishya. This is the purpose. Therefore, Krishna has begun the Chaturvarnam Maya system Gunakarma Vibhaga. Therefore, one has to understand what is the meaning of these different types of activities. Karmana Opi Bodhavam, Bodhavam Cha, Vikarmana. Vikarmana means if you cannot work, which will satisfy Krishna, that is Vikarma. That is Vikarma, profit. Because the real purpose of working is to satisfy Krishna. He is the center of all activities. Sakarmanatamabhat, Sangsiddhi Lavate Nara. Simply by satisfying the central point, Krishna, then you get Sangsiddhi. It doesn't matter whether you are a Shudra or Brahmana or engineer or lawyer. The real point is how to satisfy Krishna. But that education is lacking. So our Krishna consciousness movement is teaching how to serve Krishna from any position, it doesn't matter. Whether you are a Brahmana, Kshatriya, Vaishya, Shudra, lawyer, engineer, or film actor, or anything, it doesn't matter. But whether you are trying to satisfy Krishna, that is the point. If you have no such sense how to satisfy Krishna, then it is samayeva hi kevalam dharma sanasthita pungsa viśyapsena kathāsuja nutpādaya-virati-njati sramayeva hi kevalam. This is simply labor. It has no meaning because you are creating your own formation, next body, another body. Then that is your responsibility. You are acting like a hawk, you get the body of a hawk. You are acting like a monkey, you get the body of a monkey. If you are acting like a god, demigod, you get your body. Dharmana daimanatrena. Therefore one should know what class of work I shall be engaged in. That there are easy processes. It doesn't matter according to your qualification. You engage yourself in any work, but try to satisfy Krishna. Then your life is successful. Otherwise it is samayeva hi kevalam. Therefore Krishna says, Karmana api bodhavam, bodhavam cha vikarmana. Vikarmana means self-gratification. I explained this verse from Bhagavatam last night. Nunam pramatta kurute vikarma. This vikarmana is explained in the Bhagavatam. Nunam pramatta kurute vikarma. What is that vikarmana? Jat indriya pritaye aprinoti. Anything which is done for sense gratification, that is vikarma. So people are engaged in vikarma everywhere, all over the world. The education, the scientific advancement, culture, everything. Now culture means some dancing. Now it has become a culture. Now what is that dancing? That's sense gratification. Boys and girls dancing, ball dance. Sense gratification. That is vikarma. But here, the same dancing before the deity is bhakti. The same dancing. You dance in a theatrical performance, in a platform, that is also dancing. And here, in this stage, before the deity, if you are dancing with Hare Krishna Mahamantra, then you are making bhakti, progress. And that dancing means you are becoming entangled in your karma. Because that dancing is sense gratification, vikarmana. Nunam pramatta kuruti vikarma. Jad indriya pritaye apnati. This is what they say, nasadumanne. This is not good. yato atmanayam asallapi klesate asadeha. Asallapi, this body is not permanent. It's still asallapi, although it is not permanent, for few years only. It klesate, simply full of miserable condition. Because you have committed, executed vikarma, therefore you have got this body. It doesn't matter whether it is rich body or a poor body. Everyone has to undergo the threefold miserable condition of life. When typhoid is there, it does not discriminate that here is a rich body, I shall give him less pain. No. When the typhoid is there, either your body is rich body or poor body, you have to suffer the same pain. When you are within the womb of your mother, you have to suffer the same pain. Either you become in the queen's womb or in the cobbler's wife's womb. That's fact of situation. They do not know Janma Mrityu Chara. There are so many sufferings. In the process of birth, there are so many sufferings in the process of birth and death and old age. A rich man or poor man, when we are old, we have to suffer so many invalidity. Similarly, Janma Mrityu Jara Vyadhi, Jara and Vyadhi and Mrityu. So, we are not conscious about the suffering position of this material body. Shastra says, don't accept again any material body. Nasadu manne. This is not good that you are repeatedly getting this material body. Nasadu manne, jato atmano. Atmano, the soul, is encased in this material body. Jato atmanayam. Asannapi, of the temporary life of this body. Klesado, asadhi, ha. So, if we want to stop this miserable condition of getting another material body, then we must know what is karma, what is vikarma. That is Krishna's purpose. Karmanopi bodhabbam, bodhabbam to vikarma, na. Akarmanasta bodhabbam. Akarmana means there is no reaction. Reaction. Karma, if you do nice work, it has got reaction. It gets nice body, nice education, nice family, nice riches. This is also nice. We take it as nice. We want to go to the heavenly planet. But you do not know that even in the heavenly planet, there is the Janma Mrityu Jara Vyadhi. Therefore, Krishna does not recommend that you go to the heavenly body. He says, Abrahma Bhavana Lokan, Punaravartina Arjuna. Even if we go to the Brahma Loka, still the repetition of Bhagavan. Jadgatyana Nivartanti, Taddhama Paramamma. Jadgatyana Nivartanti. But you do not know that there is a Dhamma. If you samarada, if we can promote ourselves to that Dhamma, then na Nivartanti, Jadgatyana Nivartanti, Taddhama Paramamma. In another place, tattādi haṁ punarjanma naiti māmeti. So people have no information that Krishna, as the Supreme Lord, He has got His place, and anyone can go. How one can go? Jāti deva prata devān pitrīn jānti pitrī prata bhūtejya jānti bhūtāni madhijādi nopi jānti mā. If one becomes devoted to My worship, My business, bhakti yoga, he comes to me. In another place he says, bhaktamāma vijānāti, jāvānyasya. Therefore our only business is to understand Krishna. Yajñāte karma, this is akarma. Here it is said, akarmana api bodhabhyam, akarmanasya bodhabhyam. Akarma means without reaction. Yet, if we act for our sense gratification, the reaction is just like a soldier is killing, is getting gold medal. The same soldier, when comes home, if he kills one man, he's hanged. Why? He can say in the court, sir, when I was fighting in the battlefield, I killed so many, I got gold medal. And why you are hanging me just now? Because you have done for your own sense gratification. and that you did for government service. Therefore, any karma, if you do it for Krishna's satisfaction, that is aparamana. It has no reaction. But if you do anything for your own sense gratification, you will have to suffer the resultant action, good or bad. Therefore, Krishna says, karmano api bodhabdham bodhabdham cha vikarmana akarmanascha bodhabdham gahana karmana. It is very difficult to understand what kind of action you should do. Therefore, we have to take direction from Krishna, from the Shastra, from Guru. Then our life will be successful. Thank you very much.